Hello guys, talking about the gel electrophoresis and different types of electrophoresis techniques for a while, and this is going to be another video about native gel electrophoresis. Now, what is native gel electrophoresis? Or you may also heard the name of native PAGE or native PAGE. PAGE means polyacrylamide gel electrophoresis. It's a type of electrophoresis that we have already discussed. Now, native PAGE is another small verification, small varying part of the PAGE. So what is a native gel electrophoresis? Native means it's native is its original form, right, of something. Now, in this case, the native means original form of the protein, because you know, when you talk about native gel electrophoresis, we are definitely talking about the electrophoresis of protein samples, not DNA sample. And we know the electrophoresis of protein is conducted with polyacrylamide gel, right? Because in that case, we simply call it SDS polyacrylamide gel electrophoresis. So these are the two different terms, SDS page and native page. So SDS page, in case of SDS page, we have seen certain things. In case of SDS page, we've seen that a protein, whatever protein we take, let's say proteins are in 3D conformation, right? It is having different kind of self intra protein, different linkages, intra amino acid bonds present there. But we treat it with SDS, sodium dodecyl sulfate. Now the sodium dodecyl sulfate is a kind of detergent which is tagged with this protein, and it is having two different purpose. One is that it breaks down the different bonds that are present between those amino acids, the intra-protein interaction, the different motifs, and all those the tertiary structures are broken down into smaller fragments, and what we get is simply as a primary structure of protein. Simply amino acids are attached with each other all together. That's what the structure, the linear structure should be produced prior to the SDS page, and that's the job of SDS. And also it will tag the protein with negative charge throughout the body so that it can migrate through the electric field towards the positive electrode. That is the purpose of SDS, adding SDS in SDS page. But in native page electrophoresis, we use the electrophoresis process to separate the protein as it is. I mean, we do not allow the protein to be degraded or make them linearized. They are present, whatever 3D structure they are in, and they are separated based on their, normally based on their size, shape and charge. But remember, if we look at the SDS page, normally the proteins are separated based on their size, that is based on their molecular weight. But in case of native page electrophoresis, we can separate protein based on their shape, size and charge. So if you look at here, it is a type of page used to separate protein based on the charge, mass and shape that we have already seen. Now this is helpful in detecting different things like amino acid content. That means the different properties of amino acids, or properties, different type of amino acids, whether the protein is consisting of more hydrophobic or hydrophilic amino acid or not. Then protein-protein interaction study is possible by native gel electrophoresis. Protein nucleotide, is there any region of nucleotide or DNA that the protein can bind? So there are different domains inside the protein where the protein is having a particular unique structure with which it will bind with DNA or RNA. So if there is any structure like that, we can have an idea about those structures by using this native gel electrophoresis. Or we can also see different kind of structures like molten globule structure and different motif structures of proteins by using native gel electrophoresis. And why? Remember, normally in case of SDS, we break them down and the SDS is added so that we get linearized segments of those proteins. And then we add and load them in polyacrylamide gel, and we know they're separated based on their molecular weight. So the smaller will travel the farthest here, and then the large and large, so on, it will go on like this. But if you remember, in case of native gel electrophoresis, the idea here is that normally the proteins are present. Let's say this is a protein which is folded properly, and this protein is having its own charge. Whatever folding conformation the protein in, the protein has a own charge present. It can be slightly negative or highly negative, slight positive or hugely positive. It can be many different types. So it has a kind of its own charge. And as it is, this charge of protein depends on the amino acid sequence that are making this protein, right? So the different types of amino acid sequence, the presence of the type of amino acid sequence, denotes what kind of charge this protein will have. So once that thing is there, I mean, this is one thing to think about. And another thing is that as we are not breaking this structure down, so the thing is, in the electric field, let's say this is the electric field, we apply this electric field to a particular, let's say this, and we have loaded these proteins out there. So let's say this is a protein which is loaded out there, two different proteins. So this is the blue one, and we also loaded a green one. So we have the proteins loaded here, and as they migrate towards a particular direction, now the movement of these proteins in this electric field will depend on the net charge of the protein itself, because we are not tagging any charge to this protein on themselves, right? So it is completely based on their own charge that they have, and the charge of protein is depending upon the type of amino acid sequence are making the protein, right? That's a very important point here. So they are migrating this through this electric field depending upon their size. And if now let's say this whole movement of this protein is influenced, as it is also made up with polyacrylamide, this is influenced by the shape also and molecular weight also, because as they have a three-dimensional conformation, so a protein can have a different kind of shape, and different kind of shape of the protein allows the protein to pass through that polyacrylamide polymer pore at different rate. So if you apply the same electric field throughout the time, right, or let's say most of the cases what we do is slight electric field, or kind of we keep this neutral zone, we keep a neutral electric field throughout this place, it's all about the protein's own charge and the protein's own shape, obviously protein's own molecular weight, which takes the protein move from one direction to another and be at different positions. So what we can guess from that is that from a mixture of proteins, by looking at the position of the protein during this type of separation, we can tell a specific type of structure of protein, a specific type of structure like molten globule structure. So we know that if this is a molten globule structure of protein, if we have the molten globule structure of the protein, and if we run it with native page, it will be landing somewhere here at this gel, because every time we do the experiment, it lands kind of similarly at the same area. If we maintain the page concentration, I mean the polyacrylamide concentration at a level, that's the thing. We allow the protein to pass and migrate on their own to get more information about the protein structure, more information about the protein size and shape, right? That's why we use native gel electrophoresis instead of SDS page, because in SDS page we want those protein to be separated from each other. So majorly in SDS page we use them to actually separate them, and we actually to get the different molecular weight proteins out there. But in native gel we want to see how those proteins are behaving in the electric field. So what is the charge mass behavior of that protein in the electric field? And another important thing about this native gel electrophoresis, as those proteins are not degraded, so after this migration is done, we don't even know not to use any kind of protein tagging stain. We can use any enzymatic stain or enzymatic reaction or coloration to know the presence of the protein bands or presence of proteins, because the proteins are active at this particular point. And even we can take cut this different agar page gel open and take out the protein, and we can extract that protein, and that can be functional during this particular area. So if we see here, this is a condition we had. Normally we can run it a vertical, or we can run it the horizontal gel electrophoresis. So we load the buffer, then we load the protein sample, then we start the power supply, then we, after some time, we take out, once the process is done, we take out the gel, we stain it, and we see the position of proteins. This is the process. But remember, in this case of native versus SDS, I've already discussed, is that in SDS it is single, so you can see this straight, very resolved bands and different locations. But we don't want that in case of conventional native page. What we want is how that protein actually behaves. That's what the primary thing for us to determine using the SDS, using the native page on native electrophoresis. So that's kind of it about the native electrophoresis, and I hope this video is helping you. If you like the video, hit the like button, share this video with your friends, and obviously subscribe to this channel to get more videos like this. Thank you.